All right.
I know
you guys have been doing interviews all day. You must be hungry and tired, so I won't waste too much of your time.
No problem.
Plus, I don't know how many times you've answered the same question. You must be getting sick of it.
Wow, and I'm not a woman.
A woman, you know, at least then it'll be pleasant to look at. Yeah, so...
Well, you know, many on the stream would maybe disagree with you because they often tease me about that, but that's not the case.
All right. I'll start off with this, right? Apparently the Tekken Tag 2 netcode is similar to Soul Calibur 1, or is the same Soul Calibur netcode? Is there any changes being made to it? And how do you feel about the online so far, but the console version? Because with online being very important these days.
Definitely. ネットコードはキャリバーをベースにしていると聞いたんですけど、実際そうなのかと、まあ、それを、まあ、何か手を加えているのか改良したりとか、キャリバーのベースからで、まあ、あのオンラインみんな知っている通りすごい重要な要素ではあるので、まあ、いい具合に進んでいるのかという質問です、ね。まあ、
ネットコードってみんなそれらしく言ってるけど、
まあ、でもこの間サンディエゴで披露した
ん
です
そんなにパターンいっぱいないんだけど実は
確かに
ね、あのパターンというか、なんだろう、何をベースにしてるかっていうか、まあ、キャリバーにしたって何にしたってうち同じ会社で同じことをみんなでやってるので、鉄拳の 5DR のオンラインの頃から、こうお互いにインプルーブしていってるような感じなんですけど、結局全く同じなわけなくてやっぱタッグなので、キャリバー以上にキャラが、まあ、2倍いるわけですよね、画面に4台出ることもあるし、そもそもタッグが交代できるなので、あのタッグ用の、特別なカスタマイズっていうのは、されてるからもうタッグ専用のネットコードとも言えるんですけど、どちらかというと、言い方としては要はキャリバー結構好評だったと思うんですよ、ネット対戦の品質としては。要は、あれと同じものに品質にするというで、まあ、いい例として僕は話してるんですけど、で現に、この間のコミコン、先週のコミコンで実は初めてオンラインビルドを、皆さん披露しました。その体験会みたいになってトッププレイヤーに遊んでもらったんですけど、非常に好評だったので、まあ、ぜひ皆さんに近いうちどっかでまた体験とかね、やりたいと思います。
So、Yeah, we do get asked this quite often. And I guess the simple answer is that we do base the netcode off of Calibur, but it's not just because Calibur was well received. You know, back when we did DR Online, was the first time we did that. And then since we are in the same company, obviously we share the technology base at that current time with the other teams. Likewise with Calibur, once they implemented that and it was pretty well received, obviously we kind of received some of that technology and tailored it for Tekken Tag 2. Obviously we had to make quite a few changes because of we have four characters on screen at once. That's quite different from the Calibur. Not only that, but there's other gameplay mechanics that are unique to Tekken, so we had to do that. And it's funny you mention that because we just in San Diego for Comic-Con, we had a party for Tag 2 where we called media and all that, and some of the more outspoken players in the community, and we gave them a chance to check it out. It was pretty positive, and we hope that we have some opportunities in the future to take that build around to other communities and let them check it out, hopefully before the release of the game as well.
Cool. All right, Australia has currently been lacking several customizations compared to the Japanese and Korean Tekkenet. Is there any word on whether this will be updated, and is it in the near future? Or
オーストラリアが日本と韓国と比べてカスタマイズがテケネットでの話、韓国と日本より少ないってなって言ってるけど、それは近いうちにこうアップデートされるかって。
もうね、これね、オーストラリアに限らず中国の逆に韓国の人もいるし、マーケードって今東半球しかないんですけど、東半球のいろんな国の人、フィリピンとかもどこもかしこもですね、みんな同じこと言うんですね、自分の国だけ少ないって。そんなことないので、 それ何かのね、情報のミスだと思うんですよ。
称号のこと言ってるのかな。確か
違う違う、英語は称号ないんだっけ。でも称号はね、オープンにしたからね、この間ね。まあ、称号じゃなくてね、ね、カスタマイズで、そもそも例えばラースのなんか鎧とか上半身あるけど下半身ないとか。
ああ、はいはいはい、あ
った。でこれが足りてないんじゃないかって思われてるんですけど、実は
そういうデザイン、も
ともとそういうデザインでわざと入れてなかったりとかするものがあるから、はい、それでこう憶測してるんじゃないかなと思って。そんなことないですよ、うん、基本的にはちゃんと全部平等にやってます。
So he was saying that he gets that from a variety of different countries. When he says variety, obviously the arcade is still only in the Eastern Hemisphere with the Tekkenet and network featuresSo he gets this a lot, you know. Only Japan has some item X, or Korea has item Y, and we don't. But that's not the case. The customization should be the same. Maybe he said that one element that confuses people is, for example, Lars has this one item where the top has this certain type of armor, but he doesn't have it for the bottom. Mm. And that's just the way it is in all the regions, where some people think that because he has the top, he must have the matching set for the bottom. But that's not the case, so maybe that's leading to some people confusion about that.
That's cool. A lot of people have been wondering, I don't know if this has been covered, correct me if it has, is there a PS Vita version of Tekken Tag 2 coming out? You know, a lot of people want to practice on the run on their trip.
Me too.
I know he understands me as well. I see that smile on his face. I'll take that as a yes.
I want
that's
one too.
Fine.
まあ、これ個人的には作りたいですけどね。
そう。
今作ってるプラットフォームがあまりにも多すぎて、ね、作ってる製品もすごく多いので、はい、機会があれば作りたいとは思っています。
So, yeah, he would like a Vita version of Tag 2 as well. But as you know, we have a variety of different platforms we're making games for at the moment. And that's a lot of stuff on our plate at the moment as well. So although we would like to, currently there isn't any plans. If somehow we could, that'd be cool though.
All right, cool. All right, Tekken has been known for its mini games. Will they be brought back in Tekken Tag 2, or is there new ones that you've created?
Tag じゃなくて Tekken ってミニゲームで有名、多分ボールボーリング。
大好きだね、
ほんま。Tekken Wars。そう。あんまりにも人気あったんですけど、今回のタグ2も復活するものってありますか？それとも新しいのあるんですか？
みんなミニゲームの話大好きですよね、もう。Tekkenのミニゲーム。全部俺とプログラマー1人とデザイナー1人とか3人で作ってきてたけどね費用対効果高いですねこれね。
So,
でも今回は
Everyone, you guys love the minigames, right? I mean, he gets this a lot. Actually, he made those, all of them, actually, with just himself, one programmer and one artist. So,
That's awesome.
Very cost effective.
で、まあ、今回は実はファイトラボというものの中にまあ、ユニークなストーリーがあって、まあ、なんかミニゲーム集みたいになってるんだけど、チュートリアル的な役目も果たしていて、かつ上級者にとってはこう、ね、技をカスタマイズしたオリジナルキャラが作れるというのは、非常にありとあらゆるプレイヤーに鉄拳ファンの人にリーチできるファイトラボというものがあるんですけど、その中に、まあ、ちょっとしたあまり普段の鉄拳では見ないようなミニゲーム要素というのが結構詰まってるので、ぜひ今回ファイトラボの方注目しててください。
あれだね、E3 でほんの一部しか見せてないよね。
あ、そうそう、E3 とかで見せてるのはもうほんとごく一部。
もうあれから
途中の切り出しだから、なんかみんな今いきなり変なゲームさせられたかよくわかんないかもしれないけど、
一気にぶっ飛んだ内容にしたんですよね。
面白い。
So, everyone of course loves the minigames. This time around though, the thing we want to show off the most and have players check out, see for themselves, is the Fight Lab mode. And this has changed quite a bit from the E3 version. That was a very early build of it. So there's actually a lot of content added. It's kind of like a collection of mini games, almost, that's been prepared to help players learn different gameplay mechanics as they're playing. So rather than just a rote tutorial, we want someone to enjoy these different games and then realize they're getting better at the game. But you know, it's not just for beginners or people who are coming back after a blank of playing. We wanted the advanced players to be able to enjoy it as well. So that's why you have combat, and as you're progressing through the mode, you have access to hundreds of techniques, which you can pick and choose which ones you want to put onto him. So
yeah.
It really is a unique mode, and we hope that people will check this out. He didn't know we were going to do a stream. I mean, since he's speaking Japanese anyways, he would have told his Japanese Twitter fans out there.
I think it was kind of like a spur of the moment sort of thing.
ちょっとなんかいきなり思いついた感じで。
あ、そう
なんだ。I was going to ask. I don't know if he's going to answer this, but will Tekken Cross Street Fighter use a whole new engine or will it use the Tekken Tag engine?
Tekken Cross Street Fighter は新しいエンジンを作りますか？それともタッグのエンジンを流用する予定か？
いやまあ、タッグは鉄拳史上初画面に4体出さなきゃいけないという時点で、実はあの6のエンジンも全然使えてないので全く1から、ね、作り直しているぐらいの勢いなんですよ。だから、ね、秒が2倍ぐらいかかるしメモリも、ね、2倍ぐらい食いますし、だからそういう意味ではタッグに特化したものになっちゃってるんで、そのまま使うってことは多分とかしないです、はい、あのもうちょっと全然違うアプローチで、やります。
Well, you know, the Tag 2 engine was really developed specifically with this game in mind, since we have to have four characters on screen, which is the first time we've actually really done this. As you know, the previous tag you'd swap out completely before the next one came in. So this is the first time for four characters. It requires twice as much memory. Also, the graphical power we need twice as much to do that. So we really aren't considering using that for Tekken Cross Street Fighter. So the engine's pretty much being built from scratch for that one.
Has production actually started? Development for the game has started, or is it because it's so late into the console's life that you guys are considering going on to the next gen and topping Street Fighter Cross Tekken?
もう開発が始まってるのか、それとももう現在のこのコンソールの世代がもう古いから次の待ってる感じなのかどうかっていう質問なんで、
まあどっちの質問もはっきり言って答えられないっていうのが答えなんだけど、まあ、開発始まってるかって言ったら実はあんまり情報をあえて出してないんですけど、出してないというか言うなって言われてるんですね PR マネージャー
が
ね、なんで実はあえて言ってないだけでちゃんと水面下で動いてますよっていうのと、さらに次世代機でやるかどうかってところなんですけど、まあ、それは今は答えられないですね。ただ発表した時にあった機種で発売されないっていうのはみんな、今俺持ってる現行機で出してよって意見の方が多分多いと僕は予想してるので、それはちゃんと考慮しなきゃなというふうに、考慮しなきゃというかそっちでまず出すべきだろうなと個人的には思います。これまだ会社的な公式見解では何でもないです。
Well, we haven't really talked much about this topic, partly because, you know, we're focused on Tag 2, as you can see, and the PR folks are saying to have us and the media focus on that. So, but we are in development of the title, obviously. And it's not that we're really waiting for the next platform or not. It's hard. We can't really say a whole lot about this project yet, obviously. There's a lot we can't talk about. Mm-hmm. We can say that Harada-san personally, this isn't the company official policy or anything. It's just that if we, you know, announced it on the current generation of hardware when we did and then wait till the next generation, there might be a lot of negative feedback out there that why didn't you guys release it on the consoles we already own at that time? So if possible, maybe that's the better choice to try to release it on this current generation, if possible.
All right, fair enough. All right, no more.
Nothing's decided, and it's not official policy. That's just his thoughts on the matter.
That's fine. All right, no more about Tekken Cross Street Fighter. I know he doesn't want to answer. But I will say this. Akuma better be in the game. So just so you know.
いや、まあ、ごめん、もうテクンクロスの質問はしないんですけど、まあ、最後だけ言わせてもらうと、ぜひ号機入れてほしいんですけど。
いや、号機ね。ああ、それも
海外人気あるよな。
海外すごい人気あるよね、号機ね。
ああいう悪いやつ好きだね。デュエルジーもだって海外人気あるしね。
そう、ああいう悪いの好きだよね、みんなね。悪い日本人大好きだよね、みんなね。
いや、あ。 he seems to be quite popular abroad, right? And we were just saying that, I don't know, the non-Japanese gamers really seem to love their evil-looking Japanese dudes, like yep. Koki is one of yep. them as well. But for the Tekken series, Devil Jin, he's my personal favorite as well.
Yeah,
but
he's cool.
A lot of people abroad seem to love him too. So you guys love the evil Japanese
evil,
guys.
Evil
huh?
Japanese guys.
Evil Japanese is the evil Japanese. Capcom's Onoda.
But you know, if you guys are watching closely. If you want to see a real evil Japanese dude, that would be Ono from Capcom. So.
No, no, no. Ono looks like the good guy. Harada looks like the villain. Harada looks
like the villain. 俺は見かけが悪役なだけで、本当に悪い悪なんだ。Ono なんだぞ。
Well, he said, you know, I look like just the heel. Of course, that's just my appearance. The real evil guy is, of course, Ono.
He's one of those psychotic evil ones. That's why. This one's stereotypical.
ハラダさんはありがちなイーブルで、オノさんはそういうなんかあの心理的にこうおかしく系のこうイーブルのサイコですね。
まあな、俺日本でもなんか俺すごい悪い悪役だと言われるんだよね。なんかね。
In Japan, you know, everyone's saying he's the bad guy as well.
No, I think they just hate Street Fighter Cross Tekken. I think that's it. That's probably why.
ただ Tekken、ストクロス嫌いなだけなんじゃないのかなと。アリさんが言ってますか。
え、誰がストクロ嫌いなの。
全員
みんな。どういうことじゃん。
わからん。まあ評判悪いということ。
Next question.
Next question. Next question. All right. Little bit off topic.
Okay.
Namco is taking charge of the new Super Smash Bros. Right.
Okay.
Is Harada being called on to help out at all?
新しいスマッシュブラザーズの開発Namcoが担当することが発表されて。
はい。
原田さんがもう引っ張られてそっちにこう仕事とかそういうのも振られてたりしますか。
これね、海外だと海外って本当
みんな興味あるね。
欧州、北米、含め
逆に日本聞かれてない。
逆に海外もあの全部あれのニュースになった時ヘッドラインに鉄拳チームっていうキーワードだけになっちゃったんだよね。
はいはいはい。
いろんなキーワードが抜け落ちて、
日本は小林さんとかいろんな人が、
結局バンダイナムコで海外で名が通ってるタイトルってところでもうピックアップされるのが鉄拳しかないから、もう鉄拳っていうキーワードだけが乗っかっちゃったせいで、やたらと海外行くと俺がスマブラのこと聞かれるんだけど、
そう。
あのいいですか、スマッシュブラザーズはあくまで桜井さんがディレクションする桜井さんのゲームなので。僕がどうこういう話はありませんので、あのみんな一回落ち着こう、ね、で、はい、あの我々がああいう会社としてね、ああいうタイトル任されるというのは非常に信頼を得ている証拠ですし、現に確かにね、あのソウルキャリバーとか鉄拳とか格闘ゲームたくさん我々作ってるんで、あのテクニカル的なところでいろんな
技術のサポートとか、
ね、サポートだったりそのお互いに、いろんな情報交換ができると思っているので、あの非常に会社としては前向きです。あのそれ以上のことは僕基本的に今お酒飲んでるから余計なこといっぱい言いそうなので、
喋りません。日本のスリーみたいな感じですね。
そう、俺ね、ちょっと面白おかしく喋るとみんなヘッドラインでね、こう海外の記者が面白おかしくね書き立てるからね、すごい迷惑してるんですよ日本で。言ってもいないようなことを5倍ぐらいの話にされていつも毎回ね。だからね、俺今回に関してはあんまり余計なこと言わないので、あのみんな落ち着いてください。以上です。
Well, you know, it's funny. The reaction was quite different in Japan and in the West after the title was announced that Namco was going to be in charge of development on that. But that being said, it's clear that Sakurai-san is going to be in charge of game design on that project.And when it was announced first, everyone in Japan, you know, we had Namco's most creative talent is involved in the project, not just the Tekken team, but Ridge Racer, Soul Calibur, all of our famous franchises. But when the release and the news came to the West, most of those titles aren't as big as Tekken, so it just turned out that Namco's in charge of Smash Brothers, especially Tekken, you know? So...He got so much feedback over Twitter, and even in Japan it got kind of distorted as well. But he's not really going to be in the forefront of the game. Obviously, that's all due to Sakurai-san.
All right.
Obviously, Nintendo chose us because our experience with fighting games and the knowledge we have there So obviously that will be used as a base. Some of the technology and stuff that's in our fighting games as well will be shared with them. But Harada-san's not really going to be a game designer or anything like that on the project.
All right, cool.
And also this happens, this is kind of unusual to have him on a stream like this, and he's drinking, of course. So
it's all right. It's Australia. We're laid back. Yeah. We don't really care around here.
He drinks even more on the streams in Japan, though, and he often says things that get a lot of attention in the way he didn't intend.
Like I said,
but even when he's not drinking, sometimes when he says something in the West that causes ripples and stuff, and it's not my translation either. It's just people take something and they take the one words or whatever that they were interested in and put it into a title. And then in Japan, it turns into this huge problem. So,
like I told you before, man, this is Australia. We're very laid back. Usually there's strippers behind us when we're
Where are they now?
We only have Jean. It was too late at this time, so I apologize to Harada about that.
It's okay.
Australia is very まったりした感じで, いつもだったら背後にこうストリッパーがいるんですけど、今日ちょっと用意ができなくてすいません。
Next Evo,
用意されても困るから。
Next Evo, we go drinking. We get Markman and we go drinking.
Yeah, okay.
Ah, definitely. 次の Evo は Markman 交えて。
One last question before I let you guys go eat and drink and relax.
Drink more.
Capcom have released very little games on the arcade recently. They haven't been giving them a chance. Is Namco going to follow suit, or would Namco keep supporting the arcade scene and trying to keep it alive?
Good question. 最近カプコンのこう業務用ベースのゲームあんまりなくて減らしてる感がすごく伝わるんですけど、ナムコは同じような傾向にあるのか、それともまあ業務用に出し続ける傾向にあるのか、どうですかね。
ああ、まあ他社さんのことは俺はどうこういう立場じゃないので、あれですけど、あのナムバンダイナムコゲームズって、あのグループ的にね、ゲームをただ作ってるだけじゃなくて、皆さんご存知の昔からあのゲームアーケードを、経営してるんですね。なのでそこがアーケードをサポートしないってことはまずないので、別に格闘ゲームに限らず、いろんなタイトル出し続けてますから、それはもちろんこれからもやっていくつもりですよっていう、一番最後にものすごい地味な質問を持ってきたねこれ。
Well, he can't speak for other companies such as Capcom, but as far as Namco is concerned, we not only do we make games for the arcade, we actually own arcades and operate them, so obviously we have a large stake in continuing that. And I believe we still do have quite a lineup of titles that we create for the arcade, and that probably won't change. Not just Tekken, but other titles as well. And then you mentioned that the last question was a pretty... overly serious one for being the last question.
Yeah, well, you got to finish off a little bit serious. So let me get this straight. Well, Tekken Cross Street Fighter in the arcades very soon. Ah. Yeah.
だとすると、じゃあ Tekken Cross は業務用バージョン出るかという質問につながったんですけど。
おっと、意地悪な質問するね。
でも、
あのね、さすがにわかんないんですよ。なんとも言えないんですけど、それは市場の状況を見て判断すべきだし、どうしたもんかね、まだ分かんないですね、そこら辺は。
でもそしたらまた西洋でさ、業務用ない国は
そう欧米って
エボで不利になるとかいろんな言われるから、
だ
から
先にアーケード出されてまた発売遅れるのみたいなことで随分言われるし難しいんですよね。鉄拳って業務用出してるときは東半球が 90% のシェアで家庭を出しちゃったんで、この逆転するんですよね。 90% のシェアが北米欧州なんですよ。だってシリーズ4000万も売れてるうちの2000万もがヨーロッパでしょ、でそのあと残り1400、500本が北米でしょ、あと日本とアジアで分けてる状態でしょ、家庭は。業務用になったら逆転しますからね、これね。アジア、東半球、オセアニア一色になりますから、こんなにね、こう東半球と西半球で意見が違う格闘ゲームも珍しいので、ちょっと今後はいろいろ展開ちゃんと考えていこうと思ってます。なんでまだ答えははっきり言えません。
Well, it's kind of a difficult decision because Tekken is quite unique in that the arcade, they're still pretty much thriving in the Eastern Hemisphere, Asia, Oceania, those areas. But then when you release the consumer version, the console versions, it completely changes. The 90% of those sales come from the West, Europe, and the U.S. So it's kind of hard to please everyone, because when we release an arcade version, the people in the West who don't have vibrant arcades are saying, well, so we have to wait even longer to get a console version, or the people who have them in arcades in the country are going to be stronger tournaments and whatnot.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a problem unique to Tekken, because of the market switch so drastically between the arcade and then the console. So he hasn't really decided yet. So he can't say at this point, unfortunately.
All right, fair enough. Arada-san, thank you for your time. Michael, great
pleasure
to see you again. Thanks again. Can you just look at the camera and just say shadowloo.com in like a full villain voice, whatever? I don't care.
アクアクポク、カメラ見てシャドウルー.comって言ってもらっていいですか?パターンしてるよね。しかも鉄拳じゃないし。シャドウルー.com。All right, beautiful.
Good?
Thanks, man. Thanks for your time.
Sure.
これ小野さんに言わせた方がいいよ、シャドウルー.com。
He said you should make Ono-san say that.